Okay, so today we're talking about what it takes to be a top 10% investor, what you need to do to be better than 90% of the other investors that are out there right around the world competing for your money. I think one of the key problems is that a lot of investors enter the market and overestimate how successful they'll be. They start off with the premise that they're going to be very successful, they're going to make a lot of money, and often what happens is that they're disappointed. That disappointment takes them off course and then they somewhat give up. The top 10% of investors, from my experience, what they do is they go in and they always think about the worst case scenario. Let me give you an example. Ray Dalio, who's arguably one of the most successful investors out there in the world, who runs Bridgewater Associates in the United States. We're talking about somebody who has a net worth in excess of $15 billion, who manages hundreds of billions of dollars for clients, is in the top 100 business leaders around the world, the 69th richest person in the world, someone who's arguably very, very experienced, very, very successful at the investing game. In 2015, at the beginning of 2015, Dalio wrote to his clients and he basically wrote a manifesto about his experience and what he learned from his early days in investing. And he talks about how when he started investing, he overestimated how successful he would be. And, you know, it basically led to a blow up when there was problems in Argentina during the 1980s. The lesson, guys, is that Dalio now works on the worst possible scenario. So every time he looks at an investment, he goes for the worst possible scenario. He tries to visualize the worst case scenario. He then goes and talks to different people in order to prove himself wrong. So he starts with the worst case and then he goes and tries to solve that into a better case, and that's how he decides whether something is a good investment or not. So focusing on a worst case scenario, I think, is a key starting point in order to become different from the other 90% of investors out there who are always dwelling on the best case scenario. Again, the key point is estimate the worst possible scenario and then go about trying to disprove that. I think if you do this combined with all the other things out there that I've taught you and that will continue to show you, you'll be in a much better position to start off. If the worst case scenario is not that bad and you've spoken to a lot of people and you've basically factored in the worst that can happen, you then go about your investment journey with more clarity, with more insight, and with less disappointment. Everything that happens, you know, above your expectations is a bonus. And if your worst case scenario does pan out, there's no disappointment, there's no surprise element. I think this is very important. Hopefully you can factor it into your investments. Remember that these things that I'm talking to you about, we write to our clients, those on our premium list every single week. We don't charge anything, it's all for free. So if you want to become a top 10% investor and learn from the likes of Dalio and other successful investors, I encourage you to join up. The link is in the show notes.